Hi, I'm Glyn Jewis, and welcome to episode 100 of this almost weekly video show. Now, in this particular episode, what I want to do is show you how you can color grade your pictures, how you can add mood and atmosphere really quickly using something called color lookup tables in Photoshop. Okay, so just to set things straight right from the word go, this is actually a tutorial for those of you who are using a subscription-based version of Photoshop. So you're actually on the Creative Cloud. And that's purely because Adobe have only put the color lookup tables, or 3D LUTs, into the subscription version of Photoshop. But that being said, what exactly are they? Well, basically, they are a great way that you can color grade your pictures. They're pretty new to Photoshop, but have been around the movie and video world for a long time. So any of you Premiere Pro users or any other kind of movie editing software, you'll know exactly what it is that I'm talking about. So let's take a look at them. First of all, where we find them, how we use them, how you can create your own, and also just a couple of the pitfalls that I can show you that will help you have no problems in the future when you are actually trying to use them. So if we take a look at the picture on screen, then this is a picture that I took of a couple of guys from a group called the Bearded Villains. This is the final retouch picture, and you can probably see from the layers panel here where we've got a few adjustments at the top here. These are the ones where I'm basically adding in that final look. But I actually want to be able to use this look on many other pictures from now on. Now, I could maybe create an action, but we'll talk about actions in a short while and why they're not going to be the best thing to use. But let's just focus on these color lookup tables. Okay, so where are they then? Well, first of all, let's just get rid of all these layers here at the top. This is the picture at the stage now where I want to add in the color grading. The actual color lookup tables are found amongst the adjustment layers in the top right hand corner. So you're going to find them just up here, and there's a 3x3 grid. And when you click on that, you're going to be presented with the properties here with three drop down menus. Oops, let's just get rid of that one there. Now, when we click on the first one, as in all of them, you'll see all these different names given to these kind of like presets. And you can see that if I click on them, it's going to start adding in certain looks to the pictures. Now, nothing groundbreaking or new there, especially for those of you who like to use plugins like the one I mentioned earlier on with the Color Effects Pro. But the great thing here is these are now adjustment layers within our pictures. So what that means is we can use things like opacity if we wanted to lower the opacity. We can also start to be really creative by playing around with blend modes just to see what kind of looks we can build up. And we can add more and more and more to get that kind of final look that we want. But here is how I actually do use them. And I think you'll see at the end why there's this. I do it this particular way. So I now want to add in a mood, a look to this kind of picture. When I get to this stage, what I then do, let's just close that tab just there. What I then do is go to the image menu and choose duplicate. And when I click OK. And what that's basically going to do is give me exactly the same copy of the picture. So not only do we have the picture, we also have the layers over on the right hand side in the layers panel as well. Now on this copy, what I then do is come to the flyout menu at the top right hand corner of the layers panel and choose flatten image. And again, this will all become clear as to why I do that at the very, very end of the video. Now then, let's add a look that we want to give to this picture. So I'm going to start using these lookup tables, or these LUTs, and we'll go to the first one here, go to the first drop-down menu, and I'll choose something like tension green. Again, it's an adjustment layer, so let's just take the opacity down, so I'll take it to 40%. Let's add another one, and I'll choose the drop-down menu here. This time, I'm going to choose maybe edgy amber, and we'll reduce the opacity way down on that one to maybe 15%. And let's add just one more, a third one, and we'll go for crisp warm, and we'll take that to maybe 40%. Now, as well as these color lookup adjustment layers here, I'm going to add in a curves adjustment. And I think with this one here, I want to just bring back a little bit more detail in the shadow areas. So we'll take the bottom left-hand corner there, and we'll drag that up slightly just to bring a bit of detail back in the darks and the shadows. And let's just add a little bit of warmth in it. So where it says RGB, let's click to go to the blue channel, go to the top right-hand corner and drag that down to add a little bit of yellow, a bit of warmth into the picture. So now that we've got this look, we're going to go to the File menu, we're going to go to Export, and we're going to go to Color Lookup Tables. When we get that, we get this little dialog box comes up that says the name of the picture that we're working on, copyrighted to yourself. The quality, I'm going to leave at high here. And in the format section, you may find in your version there that by default, all four of these options are checked. Just leave it in the first one, little 3DL for 3D LUT, little tick in there, then click OK. When you click OK, Photoshop then asks you, what do you want to call it? So we'll call this one Bearded Villains. And I'll save it on my desktop in a folder called LUT, and then click save. So now then, let's just get rid of all these layers. Let's just pretend now this is a whole new picture. I now want to add that exact same look to it. Well, all I'll do is just go to the adjustment layers, click on the color lookup adjustment layer. We've got the three options. Let's click on the first menu, click on it once to open it, click on again where it says load, and then just navigate to where those LUTs are that you've created and choose the one you want, click open, and it applies it. So it's very, very quick. Now, the thing with using actions, you may be thinking, now, why don't I just create an action? Well, when you create an action, you're recording everything that you do within Photoshop, and that includes the name of the layers. Now, you may find that when you try to use the action on a picture in the future, that the layers within the picture you're working on aren't named exactly the same. So when you try to run that action, it may look for the original names of the layers, and it starts, because it can't find them, it starts to throw a bit of a hissy fit, and it may cause problems and may not work. With the color lookup tables, it doesn't care what the layers are called, it just applies it with one click. So that's how we can use them. I've shown you can use the blend modes on them, you can lower the opacities, just to get really, really creative with them. Now let's look at the pitfalls, things that you need to be aware of when you're doing it. Now the first one is this. When you're creating them, you have to have a layer that is a background layer and it's locked. Let me just show you what happens if you don't have that. I'm going to unlock this layer and we'll just create one look. Let's just go down to here. We'll go down to crisp winter, let's say, something like that. And let's say now I want to save this out as my own lookup table that I can use later on. Well, we go to the file menu, we choose export, and we choose color lookup tables. But now when I click on it, we get this warning box that comes up saying, could not export color lookup tables because this document has no background. So you have to have a background layer that's locked. So click OK. Let's go back to that layer. In fact, let's just delete that. So now that we've got this layer that isn't a background, let's turn it into a background by going layer, new, background from layer. Then let's try again. Let's just create that same look. We've got crisp winter. Now let's go file, export, color lookup tables, and there we go. Carry on as normal, we're not now getting that warning dialog box come up. So let's just cancel that one. Now the other one is, you'll notice, or remember before rather, that rather than me creating the lookup table at this particular stage where we've got all the layers in the original picture and then saving it, I actually created a duplicate, flattened it, and then made it. This is why. Let's just say we want to create that same look with this picture here, with all the layers below it. I'll go to the 3D LUTs, the color lookup tables, and we'll create the same look. So tension green down to 40%. We'll add a second color lookup and we'll go to edgy amber, take that down to 15%. Let's add that third one in. This one we're gonna choose maybe crisp warm, take that down to 40%. And then that final layer that we had was that curves layer where we increase the detail in the shadow areas. We went to the blue channel and then we added in some yellow, some warmth into the picture like so. So nothing different so far. Now then, let's say that we want to save that look. So we go to file, export, and we go color lookup tables. No warning dialog box appears. We get the name of the file here, the copyright, the quality, the 3DL is checked. We click OK. Everything seems fine at the moment. We'll then name this one Bearded Villains 2. And we'll go to the desktop and we'll put it in that same folder where my original one was saved. So we've got Bearded Villains and now we've got one that we just created called Bearded Villains 2 and we'll click save. Nothing different so far, but let's now delete all these layers and say that we've now done all this retouching and all we want to do is add that final look to our picture. We know we created a 3D LUT, a color lookup table for it. So we click on the color lookup adjustment layer. We click on the first menu, click again where it says load, navigate to the folder where we saved our looks. Let's just choose the one that was called Bearded Villains 2 and then click open. Now you might think that nothing seems that different until I zoom in, because now look. Look at his clothing. It's all gone kind of weird. Something's gone seriously wrong here. So it really doesn't like it when you create these lookup tables when you have other layers below them that aren't just the background layer. So I hope that makes sense. So keep things nice and simple. If, however, we now apply the color lookup table from the original one we created on our duplicate image. So we go to load 3D LUT, choose the one that was just called Bearded Villains, and then open, we can see there's absolutely no problems and the exact look we're after has been applied. So that there is color lookup adjustments. Absolutely fantastic. I really do love these. And I'll be honest with you, in the past sort of week or month or so, I haven't even bothered going into my usual method of coloring my pictures, which is where I'm using all these ones here, Nick Collection, Mac Fun, and Topaz. So, right, don't forget, if you like the content, make sure that you let others know about it. Let's share it out. This is now episode 100. So those of you who stuck with me all the way through, thank you so much. Obviously, we're going to continue, but a huge thanks from me. But please, please share it out there. It'd be great if you could do that. If you haven't subscribed already, make sure you tick that little subscribe button there, which is just a way, another way of showing some support. But you'll also get to know when there's a new video that's been released. And if you want the same file that you can see on screen now, that so that you can get to working straight away to try out these lookup tables so that you can get to know the techniques, just go to my website, join the email group by putting your email address in there, and then you'll get access to a page where you can download all the files that go with all the YouTube videos. But that's it. Thanks again. Episode 100, we are done. I'll see you next week for a new one.